In a few days' time, we will probably know the exact setting of where Task Force 141 is going to be operating, which it's probably going to be globally. Let's not get it wrong, but they have to have a focus. They have to have a villain, if you will, an antagonist, whether that be a person or a group, it doesn't matter. There has to be a bad guy. And it looks like we actually have some semi-confirmation from Infinity Ward themselves on a previous leak that was posted a while back on where our setting is actually going to be. Welcome to the page, everybody. Jimmy or Chaos, thank you for all the love and support. Guys, do me a favor. There's two links at the top of the description. One of them goes to Facebook. One of them goes to Instagram. We are officially partnered with Facebook Gaming, and there is a ton of gaming content over there every single day. A ton of exclusive stuff as well. You probably wouldn't even recognize the page. And the same for Instagram. We cover everything pop culture, gaming, technology. Go check them out if you guys have a second. I truly, truly appreciate it. So let's get into this. This is going to be a quick one. Infinity Ward quote tweeted Call of Duty where they said the ultimate weapon is team, and they gave the worldwide reveal. We know it's June 8th. We know June 9th. We're going to get gameplay reveal. It's going to be a really good week. Next week is National Modern Warfare 2 week in my mind. I've dubbed it that. But anyway, Infinity Ward quote tweeted him and said, weapons hot, vaqueros. Now, if you translate that, that means weapons hot, cowboys. Now, if we go back to this leak that came out a while back about the setting of the Modern Warfare 2 campaign, they said that it was going to be centered around the cartel, specifically the Colombian drug cartels. That's right. In the Video Games Chronicle article, I'm pretty sure our guy Tom Henderson was talking about it, and they were talking about the secret name being Project Cortez when they data mined the list of GeForce Now games. Now, they went on to say that the campaign would involve a U.S. Special Forces team, Task Force 141, fighting a covert war against Colombian drug cartels. Now, I don't know how we segue from Modern Warfare 2019's ending over to Colombian drug cartels, but I'm sure they'll figure it out. And they said it's going to be a covert war. So this is not a up in front in your face type war. This is going to be more of a special ops behind the scenes in the shadows type war. That article even goes on to try to link Modern Warfare 2's alleged codename, which was Project Cortez, to the 1994 Harrison Ford movie, Clear and Present Danger. If you've never seen it, you should. It's a classic. And the main antagonist, or the main villain in that movie, was a character called Colonel Felix Cortez. Project Cortez, Colombian drug cartel. I mean, you can put it all together. I don't think this is a tinfoil hat deal at all. I think this makes a lot of sense, and I think this is a good direction to go with it. You've got Task Force 141, and they are going after a huge drug cartel. So we'll see how it all plays out. We'll have answers pretty soon, but I wanted to show you guys that because Infinity Ward, well, they're calling us all cowboys. And we could put the tinfoil hat on for a second and say, that means we have confirmation that we will get a horse level. Do you guys remember the Black Ops horse level where we got to ride a horse? I want to ride a horse in Modern Warfare 2. I'll see you guys soon.